So Dan Goosen, we're here at your office. Who's here today? Can you introduce us?
Well, I can't believe that you finally get to me after all this time with Pete. Is he the best, though?
He is the best.
I mean, what better ambassador for the Money Baseball League than Pete Rose?
Get you.
On the phone with us, baseball legend, one of the greatest players ever, Charlie Hustle, Pete Rose. Pete, how you feeling today?
I'm doing okay. I'm over in Reds country, Cincinnati, Ohio. Of course, the Reds are playing an important series in St. Louis starting tonight. And I think 13 of the next 13 days, I think the Reds and the Pirates and the Cardinals are all playing each other, which should be very interesting.
There's a new baseball league. And can you explain to me about it, about your involvement in it?
You mean the money baseball?
The money baseball. It sounds like, you know, Mayweather's the money team. This is the money baseball, not related to Mayweather.
No, we're having a tournament out there at the Cal Irvine, and it's an opportunity. I mean, I think there's 12 or 14 teams going to participate in a tournament. And it gives a lot of guys that don't have minor league contracts or a lot of guys that think they're good enough to play in the minor leagues, potentially big league someday, an opportunity to play. And we'll have scouts out there and college coaches. And this is our first time doing it. And we're going to do it again in the New Year's that weekend in Las Vegas. There'll probably be 34, 35 teams in that one. So we're starting off and we're going to do it right. And I'm looking forward to it. It's next weekend. Just make them feel at home and make them feel that, the good people are watching them play. That's all you can do.
You know,
I'm not going to manage. I'm not going to coach. I'm not going to be the announcer. But I'm like the endorser. I mean, I'm like the guy that believes in it. I'm the guy that believes in giving young players an opportunity, and everybody can't sign a professional contract. There's a lot of guys who don't get a professional contract that should have got one or could get one, and we're going to see some of these guys, and I'm not saying everybody's going to sign a professional contract, but I wouldn't be a bit surprised if you don't see several guys from this tournament end up in independent league ball or minor league baseball, and all that is an opportunity to try to play for the big leagues.
All right. Thank you so much, Pete Rose. We appreciate it. And we look forward to seeing you in the Hall of Fame one day.
All right. You have a good day. Thanks for calling.
He's a very humble guy, as big as he is. No ego, just himself.
Well, you got to remember, when everything was on the line on that baseball field, you know darn well the one guy that could come through was Pete Rose. He either did it with his bat, with his legs, with his glove, whatever it was. He always got his team better, and he was one of the greatest of all time. But I'm here with the guys right now. We got Jason, we've got Steve, and we've got Ty, all three former great high school, college, and pro baseball players that, I think have lived what this dream is all about, and trying to create it for young men that they didn't have a chance to have anyone create for themselves, to create it for these young kids that are coming up that don't have that opportunity to really go out there and show their talent throughout the years. And they'll be able to explain it a lot better than I can, but let the Triple Crown team work right here.
So we have American Idol, where people try out and they win $1 million. And now, if you're a baseball player, this is what you've been waiting for, this opportunity. So can you explain to me kind of?
Well, my name is Jason. What it's real similar like is the World Series of Poker meets baseball. In a concept where you're able to go out and compete in tournament play and give yourself an opportunity to go win money. And in this concept, basic for guys that come out and play in local leagues and tournaments, where they go out and chip in a couple of bucks to go out and play for plastic trophies and plastic rings, we feel that there's another level to that. And obviously,
there's Liberace in the background.
And obviously, I mean, at this point, that's kind of where we're at, giving the dream back to baseball players, giving them a shot to be able to go make a living outside of the majors, to be able to put themselves in front of scouts, agents, and on the best baseball fields with the best umpires, and being able to compete at a very high level, and at the same time being able the chance to make a living doing that.
So if I'm a player and I'm watching this, where do I start? Where do I go?
Well, you can start with the website. It's moneysports.com.
and sign up. You can register as a player and give us all your information. Let us know what part of the country you're from, what position you play, what kind of affiliations you may have with local leagues, and also want to know what your experience is. And there's a couple ways to participate. You can either bring your own team or you can sign up as a player, and we'll make sure and find a good team for you. So it's pretty simple.
And can anyone try out, or do you have to be a superstar?
Well, anybody can play in the Money Baseball League as long as you're out of the big leagues for 12 months. Can't currently be on a professional contract. So, yeah, you bring your team, you bring your money, you put your money where your mouth is, and you come out and compete without politics, being involved in the game. There's no one that can stop you from coming out and playing in the Money Baseball League, no matter who you are. As long as you're 18 and over and you have a team or want to be placed on a team, you're going to play in the Money Baseball League and have a chance to win money.
You guys heard, of course, Weekend Warriors. People come out and think they're like Michael Jordan on a basketball court and they're Barry Bonds. But here's an opportunity for someone to live their dream. How much does it cost for me to have this shot?
Well, for example, the first tournament only cost about $100 per player to play on the team.
That's it?
Absolutely.
And it could lead to a professional contract? It could lead to...
Well, at the end of the day, what every baseball player looks for is going to be different. One guy really just wants to play in front of fans for the first time. One guy wants a chance to meet Pete Rose. I mean, who in the world that loves baseball doesn't want to meet the greatest player of all time? And for other guys, it's extending their career. They really want another chance at attaining that lofty goal of playing in front of, you know, tens of thousands of people and making millions of dollars in the big leagues. And this definitely could be the ability for them to do that, to get some more exposure.
And then, let me ask you this. How are you involved in all this?
I used to be one of the greatest ball players of all time. You know, it's funny, Ellie. You know, growing up, playing baseball was my life. I showed you a few pictures of my brother, Greg, who signed with the Dodgers and played with the Mets and Seattle Pilots. But, you know, baseball and boxing, it was really in the goose and blood. And if there's one thing that I do remember, because I wasn't good enough to play the pros, but I was good enough to go out there and compete and play. And throughout the years, I mean, I can even remember when I was doing 10 Goose Boxing. You're too young for this, but Bill will remember that every city that we used to go into, I'd organize teams of media against the boxing side. And when we go into Iowa, for instance, for a Michael Nunn event, we would have a game, an actual game that the media would write about. We'd have fans out there. That's how much that a real baseball players want to be playing out there actively. So if I wasn't in that boxing business, I would have still been striving to get into the major leagues by hook or crook. And this is a way that for someone that doesn't have boxing in their background and as a business, to be able to go out there, still play the game, which they're doing now for nothing and really with no outlet to try to parlay this into the bigger major league scene to be seen. But it gives them that opportunity now to earn a living from it and have the opportunity to make some waves where scouts will come out there, take a look at you. That's why Pete's involved. Pete's all about opportunity. You know, a lot of people don't know this. He wasn't well regarded as a future professional player. As a matter of fact, if it wasn't for his uncle, he wouldn't be playing pro baseball when he did. So he likes the opportunity of the dark horse of the young man that was overlooked for whatever reason. You look at the background of all these three young men right here. All of them were kind of like All-Americans and led the leagues and everything that they did. And, you know, that 1%, I think, of all the kids in the United States, and you throw in all the other countries now that are playing pro ball, 1% of these college kids and high school kids are playing in the major leagues. That leaves a big, big drop of 99% of a pool of players that someone probably missed when they were in high school or college, that didn't make the pros, didn't get drafted, that this 99%, someone's going to explode and be seen and accomplish something that was overlooked when they were in their school days. So I love the concept. If I was playing baseball, I didn't have a real profession yet, and I could go out there and make 25, 50, 100,000 as a team, sign me up.
Just like that. So let me ask you guys, who's the best or the greatest baseball player ever?
Pete Rose.
Well, you're lucky you said that, Jason, okay? I would have told Pete that.
Who do you think?
Pete Rose.
I think it boils down to Charlie Hustle. There's absolutely no doubt no one's ever played the game like him.
Why? What made Pete Rose so special?
Every single play, he gave absolutely every ounce of energy that he possibly had. And I've never seen anyone be able to match that on a baseball field in my life.
So now for all three of you to be working with him, what's that like?
Well, it's nice when you get a partner who's a winner, because like many of great baseball players know, winning is everything. If you're a winner, you're going to be a great baseball player. So having a guy like Pete on the team is, there's no value that you can put on that.
Absolutely agree. I mean, Pete being on our team is by far in my mind, the biggest accomplishment we've made to this point. Being able to have an opportunity to give a guy a good side of things as far as to what we're trying to do with our community in baseball and what we're trying to implement into people's minds as far as how he is as an individual. And having Pete Rose on board to me is by far the best thing I've ever seen.
Let me add one thing to that too, because the 9 years that I've been working with Pete, never ever has he said he's the greatest player of all time, even though really, I mean, it's a great argument that he is the greatest of all time. I mean, he's accomplished a lot. He still holds 20 some odd major league records.
They won't be broken.
You know, he's just done things that will never be broken, as you said. But having this conversation with Pete through the years, he's always said there's the greatest one is. Do you know who he says the greatest one is? Who do you guys think?
I would have to guess Ted Williams.
Huh?
Willie Mays.
I was going to guess Willie Mays.
Babe Ruth. He thinks he's the greatest all-time player.
We could certainly pitch.
Huh? Who could? What do you mean? He did everything.
He could throw back a hot dog.
Babe Ruth did everything, but let's confirm this. Let's get Pete on the phone.
All right, let's ask him.
Okay.
Pete Rose now coming up on the phone, and it's not staged or anything.
No, look, I mean, we're gonna be right here.
Early in a minute, they're gonna tell you where and when the tournament is being held.
Okay.
On Labor Day weekend.
And the website one more time.
Okay, Pete. One last question, Allie.
Who is the greatest baseball player of all time?
A guy by the name of George Herman Babe Ruth.
Why? Why Babe Ruth?
Because Babe Ruth did something that I don't think any other athlete in our country could do. He saved the game by his presence. I don't know if a football player could do that, a basketball player, a hockey player, that could just go to this town or that town, which he did, and sell out every game so the other teams could grow. But he's got great records. He still has pitching records. And he hit 714 home runs when it was like hitting a rock.
Yeah, but he was juiced up on those hot dogs.
Yeah, he was juiced up on hot dogs.
Hey, Pete, so Jason, Steve, and Ty are here also, and they all said that you were the greatest one of all time.
Well, you probably have to say that I was the greatest utility player of all time. But I say that for this reason. Because I played five positions and I've switched back. So I'd be a good guy on your team because I could play any position you need someone to play, plus I could pinch hit from both sides of the plate.
Well, if you measure success in wins, I think you got that title.
How many records do you hold, Pete?
I don't know. I got a lot of them. I mean, but a lot of people don't look at at-bats or games played, things like that. But I got, hits and winning games, five-hit games, four-hit games, three-hit games, five positions over 500 games, doubles, runs scored. I mean, I got, all those kind of records.
Those are good utility records.
Well, I mean, just like on the All-Century team, you know, I made it as an outfielder, which was right, because I played outfield and I won all my bat titles, and I played mostly in the outfield. But then I played, you know, second base for 3 years, and I played third base for 4 or 5 years, and I played first base for 5 or 6 years. So, you know, you have to play to get at bats in the National League. There ain't no DH.
Yep.
Pete, what's your favorite record of yours personally and why?
1,992 winning games.
Will anyone ever break that, Pete?
You play, no. No. That's why you play the game.
Yep, the win. All right, Pete.
Thank you, Pete.
Thank you, buddy.
Thanks, Pete.
Thanks, Pete.
All right, guys.
See ya.
All right, see ya.
So when is the first game, the first tournament, and again, the website where people want to go to get more information?
Our first tournament is going to be Labor Day weekend, this coming Labor Day. It's actually this coming weekend, August 31st, September 1st, and September 2nd. It's going to be played out in Orange County. You can check the website out at moneysports.com to get all your information and as well as even to sign up.
Yeah, bring your friends and your family. Come on out, buy a hot dog, get to meet Pete Rose, and watch two teams of guys that all think that they should either be an independent minor league or pro ball play against each other and have a chance to finally win a total of $15,000. These are gentlemen that have been paying a lot of money for a long time to better their career and better themselves as baseball players and never had an opportunity to play for money. So it's a big deal for them, and it's a big deal for baseball players across the globe.
If you're a baseball fan, I'll be honest with you. You're going to get to see some guys that should have been drafted that never got a chance. You're going to see about a half a dozen guys that got up to AA, AAA, and even into the major leagues for a short while that are going to battle it out on the field for a check of $15,000. That's on Monday night, Labor Day, 5:30 p.m. at UC Irvine. And if you really like baseball as much as I do, you might want to check out the Home Run Derby, which is going to be Sunday night, also at UC Irvine at 5:30.
Bill, what do you think? Baseball had a black eye this year, but it looks like this is a great thing.
Oh, well, this is the guys, the founders here, they compare it to the World Series of Poker. And I do, in a sense, only these kids that are going to be playing on Saturday, Sunday, and Monday at UC Irvine in Orange County, these kids are a lot more wholesome than those characters we see on World Series of Poker. These are kids that are still dreaming their dream. Everybody that ever played baseball as a little kid always dreamed about being a professional player, about making it to the majors, about hitting the game-winning home run, or being another Sandy Koufax. These athletes, elite athletes, are dreaming their dream. So if you love baseball, and we all love baseball, come out and see them this Saturday, Sunday, and Monday at UC Irvine.
There you have it. You heard it here first. Stay tuned for EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting. Take a step back.